Good afternoon. My name is James Wanjel. I work for African Conservation Center. What you're about to present is a project that has been done in collaboration with other institutions, that is museums and Sabil Africa. I'm just going to do the first part, which is just to explain the design part of it, and then we'll, my friend Patrick is going to present on the other section of the publishing part of it. So ACC, that is who we are. We are an NGO that has a lot of interest in biodiversity. We do not generate a lot of information, but we collaborate with other people who already have information so that we can be able to bring out the goals that we have set for ourselves. We mainly look at how we can be able to integrate knowledge, environment, and livelihoods. And we do a lot of programs that relate to livelihoods and environmental matters. The biodiversity portal that we've been trying to develop since 2010, we realized if we are going to look for softwares that are paid for, it's going to be expensive, and so we decided to use open source programs or softwares that can be easily available to most of us. And because we wanted to develop tools that can be shared among us, institutions like us, so we decided to pick on these tools. This is what we've been using. And all these are open source tools. So the structure is supposed to be like that. That as ACC, we intended to host the server that is going to host all the biodiversity information that you can find. And that is the circle, the square at the center. And then we are using PostgreSQL and PostGIS components to be able to handle GIS stuff. And then we intend to have a map server, and that map server is going to be provided for by our partner, Sabil Africa. And then we wanted to come up with a way where we can have data layers that are already cleaned up, that are already been confirmed to be standard layers that can be used. And then we host them on our server, and then we can be able to access them online from wherever you may be. The other part is internally, we've been able to do as a local user, if you're within our network, you can be able to access the data that is on the ACC server using your QGIS or ArcGIS if you have. And then we also expect some external data that can be accessed. When we look at external data, we're looking like institutions like National Museums of Kenya, Kenya Wildlife Service, DRSRS, who does remote sensing and they count mammals in the country. Then we also have a component that is supposed to be dealing with administrative issues, access rights, and if there are any fine-tuning that need to be done on the either the programs that you're using or the data itself. Then below here we have the central data. We have data for various research that has been done. We have data for conservation program we have in Amboseli. We have data for elephant project that we have done in Magadi. And we also have another project in Nanyuki, Raikipia, that we deal with baboons. So those are the main areas of concentration. And this is the way we expect the portal to behave, that you have a spatial data component that is accessing the data that you have saved on our server and using PostgreSQL. So we have interaction between the spatial component and the server, the database server. Then we also have users accessing or sharing that data from a central point. Then from there, I just want to demonstrate a bit on the tools as they appear. So we have we have the PostgreSQL, and this is how the shapefile or layers appear when they are on the database. So this is how the layers appear, and they are just, you may think they are just normal tables. We have data from museums that we got from them, and you can view. It is not the cleanest of the data that you can find, but it's good. We used it for the purposes that we wanted to achieve. And we did this when we were doing a project, a climate change project. So that is the interface for PostgreSQL database, and then we have the GIS, and you can be able to retrieve now the data that I'm displaying on the Kenya map. All that is saved on our server. I mean, the same kind of setup that I have in the office on my laptop, so you can access the layers. So instead of picking it as a file, you go to the database. You go to the database, and then of course you have the credentials. You put your password. This is one of the issues that we had a lot of problem with, the projection issues, but John has really assisted me on this. So I'm going to be sorting out my ears now after this. That is one of the things I've learned so much from this end. So you can be able now to establish a connection from QGIS and be able to retrieve the layers that you have from PostgreSQL. So I can pick on any layer and open. And of course with the projection issues, these ones, so you can be able to display them the way you want. So that is one advantage. That one has issues of projection, but that one is already sorted out. So the layer I've just opened is that one, the HH2000S, and because of projection issues, that is the reason why it is not being overlaid on the Kenyan map. But John has helped me to be able to sort that out. So I'll clean my layers again and take them back to the database. The other thing is when you have other layers, you can get, if you have layers that you have saved as files on your machine or on a flash disk or whatever it may be, you can be able to save them to the database by picking on a layer. So whatever your layer may be, you can pick it up, and as long as it's a shapefile, you can be able to pick it and be able to save it to the database. So when you want to save a layer, you come here, you go to QGIS, you pick on that tool. You need to connect to the database to be able to take that And then you can add the layers that you want to take to the to drop to the database after they are cleaned. Of course, the most important thing is the layers that you want to put in the central sharing database, they must be layers that have been checked and rechecked and found to be okay and working, so that when you take them to the database for sharing, there will be layers that you don't need to go and work out again at a later date. So that is the whole essence of having a central place where you can be able to see all your data. So currently we are doing a project that we are gathering data from different institutions, the ATRAS of Kenya, and it's going to be we are going to be getting data that is has different projection and all these other issues, and we'll need to find a way of being able to create the map, and like that one, now it won't go because it has issues that we need to sort out. So those are some of the things that I do as a database administrator, and my coming here and the course that we have learned, I've learned a lot of skills, and my DIS skills are not very good, but I'm slowly improving on that, and because I have an IT background, I didn't know about GIS much, but since I joined BITC, I've done a bit of GIS, and I'm picking up from the various training that I've been doing. So that's what we wanted to demo, and this is the data for plants before we transformed it into a shapefile. So my colleague Patrick is going to show us how we did the portal now a bit using the scripting, and but all this is running under GeoServer. So the layers that we pull, you'll pull them for him to be able to pick them and display them on the visual tool, that the portal at the front end of the tool. Then we bring in the interface between the Postgres database and the GeoServer sits at the middle, and then we have the portal at the front end. So the layers are not appearing because I don't have them here, but this is something that we've used, and he's going to show us the rest of the presentation that has all the other details and the other capabilities. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, James, for that nice presentation and this introduction. My name is Abdi Kabala, and I work with RCMRD, that is the Regional Center for Mapping of Resources for Development. And RCMRD is intergovernmental institution, and it helps about 19 member countries. As you can see that map there, that's just a web page of our organization. We have 19 member countries at the moment, spread out in the northern and the southern parts of Africa. And we'll be just sponsored by the member countries. So they pay an annual subscription fee, and we do offer services like advisory services, technical services, etc. So in conjunction with the National Museums of Kenya and the African Conservation Center, we pulled up our efforts to come up with a biodiversity data. This is just mostly occurrence data from the National Museums of Kenya. And I'm just picking up from where Wanjao left, James. And this is a service that is currently running, it's online. We have published it. And we have also made the metadata available. And our metadata we published them through the S-Ranger portal. So at the moment, some of our servers are not working properly, but we have an S-Ranger portal. And I'm trying to log in, but it's not really working properly. So I'll just do a demo using the general one. But we have our metadata in ISO 19.13. It is in ISO standards 19.115 standard. So I'll shortly do a demo here, And maybe before I go there, I'll try to show what I've done with the data. I think Ojo left some few things back. So I tried to make a few maps, and these are just desktop applications I was using. I was using DivaGIS to do richness analysis and to do some evenness analysis. Those are basically density maps. And after that, I exported my data to ArcGIS, some of it, not all of it, because you know we have limitation with using GeoServer and Postgres. Basically, Postgres can be able to handle a lot of polygons and vector data, but when it comes to raster data, we are forced to use ArcGIS and ArcGIS Server. Yeah, but I won't be able to show the interface here because I think it's not working at the moment because I'm part of our service actually at a maintenance exercise. So I'll try to do a demo here, a short, very short one. It won't be boring, I hope. So I'll try to search for bats, and I'll click there. Hope it's going to load. It's taking a bit of time.
No pressure.
So as it is trying to load, I try to explain how we have published our metadata. We are using S3 portal, which is also an open source. And basically, it's also online. And you can just, you can do a browse. I prefer to go browse and Google search. That one is loading much faster. And I'll check what you can do here. So we have customized the same for our organization. It's called Javier Geoportal Data, or Geoportal Server, rather. And all my metadata that I just created, I put them under biology and ecology. So I'll share the links after this demo with anyone who's interested in them, and then you'll be able to at least browse our data. See if this is still uploading. I think it's the same server problem that you're experiencing. I'll try to reload the page again. Sorry, it's taking a while. It's becoming for it now. I think it's letting me down. So I think I won't be able to show this demo today, and I'll just be planning some other days when I'll be facing these problems with our servers. Okay, thank you.